the importance of the flu vaccine in particular this year, and what do we know about the COVID-19 vaccine candidates currently in clinical trials. Hi, my name is Mark Johnson. I'm an infectious doctor at Confluence Health, and I wanted to talk to you for a moment about those two important topics. This year, more than ever, flu vaccine will be so important. We know that it is incredibly difficult to differentiate COVID-19 and influenza based on symptoms alone. So to make that diagnosis and differentiate between those viruses when someone presents with those symptoms, we would need to do a test. But prevention for viruses is the best strategy of how to treat them. And so getting your flu vaccine this year, starting now, is so critically important. We know that individuals who have two viral infections at once, or individuals who are infected with COVID-19 and are recovering and then develop influenza, would have much more complicated clinical courses and higher likelihood of complications and or death. The flu vaccine this year is a quadrivalent vaccine, so it protects us against two strains of flu A and two strains of flu B. And of course, the flu virus changes so much every year that we have to get vaccinated every single year. The vaccine we use does not contain preservatives, and it contains only a tiny bit of viral protein. And so the vaccine itself cannot actually give you influenza illness. You may develop some low-grade fevers or muscle aches, which is your body's manifestation of the immune system providing a protective response after immunization. And so that's normal. But you can't actually get the flu illness from the flu vaccine in its current formulations. So again, this year, flu vaccine is going to be so incredibly important. The other thing I wanted to talk about was, what do we know about the COVID-19 vaccine candidates? Of course, there have been multiple vaccine candidates you might have heard about in the news. There are currently five in the latest stage of clinical trials, which we call phase 3. And all of these vaccines work in a similar way. They're exposing you to a small bit of the virus, not the whole virus. You can't actually get infected when you get vaccinated, and it generates a protective immune response. But what we don't yet know about these vaccines is how long they're going to be effective for, and time will tell in that regard. And we also don't know which of these vaccine candidates will prove to be both safe and effective, and that is what the ongoing clinical trials are designed to do. Now, the initial small trials look at, is a vaccine safe in a small number of individuals, and whether it generates an appropriate antibody response. But these current late-stage vaccine trials called phase 3 clinical trials are designed to see if when we give the vaccine to a group of individuals who are potentially going to be exposed in the future versus individuals who have received placebo or just salt water, is there a difference in how many people get infected? In other words, is the vaccine protective? And so those trials are ongoing, and so we are anxiously awaiting the results from those trials. The vaccine types, there's one called an mRNA vaccine. There's another type called a protein subunit vaccine, and another is a viral vector vaccine. And these are vaccine platforms that have been well studied in the past, and because we knew how these vaccine types would work, they were able to be rapidly put into production and synthesis and clinical trials specifically for COVID-19. But we're still waiting for that data, and until that day comes, until we know we have a safe and effective vaccine, we're not going to recommend that vaccine, and of course, it's just simply not available. We know that with vaccine clinical trials, there are a number of regulatory processes and independent reviews that occur, and so it's pretty common for vaccine trials to be temporarily held as they evaluate outcome measures about safety and efficacy. And so if you've heard something in the news about a vaccine trial being temporarily halted, that's a normal process in a clinical trial, and that's not concerning. Prevention, as I said, is the key for viral disease, and we do have more treatment options available, but they're always limited when it comes to viruses. Viruses tend to trigger severe manifestations for which antivirals and some of our immune modulators just don't help. And you might have heard in the media about some experimental recombinant antibodies. That can be thought of a bridge until we get effective vaccines, but those remain experimental in clinical trials as well. So I hope I've imparted on you some basic information about where we are in COVID-19 vaccine clinical trials. And I would just like to conclude by saying again, getting your flu vaccine now is so critically important. We are far from being done with this COVID-19 pandemic. And having a safe and effective vaccine for COVID-19 is a huge and important part of that pandemic response. And rest assured that your physicians or physician assistant or nurse practitioner is not going to recommend a COVID-19 vaccine until it is known to be safe and effective. And we're still waiting for that. So thanks so much for your time. Again, this is Mark Johnson, Infectious Disease at Confluence Health. I hope you have a great day and stay safe.